Alien Planet is a made-for-TV movie created by Discovery Channel. It has the premise of a Hollywood movie with spaceships from Earth traveling to a never-before-seen planet filled with giant aliens, but it's done in the style of a documentary. The movie is basically two related scientific issues combined. Firstly, it delves into the idea of finding life on other planets, how astronomers would go about doing it, and what it would mean to make such a significant discovery. Secondly, it speculates what extraterrestrial life could actually be like. Even though only microscopic organisms in bodies of water seem what we would be most likely to find, it's not quite enough to make for an entertaining story. So the movie creates an entire speculative planet with its own landscape, weather patterns, and biological ecosystems. The setup in a nutshell is that in the future, astronomers have sent an unmanned craft into deep space to find alien life. On board are probes equipped with features and abilities that will allow them to analyze aspects of the planet they land on. After landing, we follow two probes as they encounter strange alien plants and animals in their daily lives. It's all very well paced, taking us from scene to scene, each with a variety of interesting situations. Every so often, it cuts back to scientists talking to the camera both about the speculative creatures in the movie as if they were real, and also the realities of the search for alien life. The aspect of the film I thought was the most well thought out was with the probes. Historically, we've always sent probes way before sending astronauts to new worlds, so the main characters that carry this story are robots, not people. The satellites and probes in the movie have a plethora of tools to survey the planet with, and every time they introduce a new aspect of the technology, you can't help but nod your head in agreement at how all these things would be necessary for surveying a new planet. For example, rather than rolling on wheels or tracks, the probes float using air sacs and thrusters, allowing them to move more quickly. They also establish that on top of the obvious features like cameras, they have deployable weather balloons to detect incoming storms, expendable mini-probes for dangerous situations, and tons of other contingency-based features that the average viewer probably wouldn't have thought of. The faces they have also make them more relatable, a smart choice on the designer's part. I even like the little detail of having one of the probes malfunction and crash at the beginning, reminding us that in space missions, sometimes things inevitably go wrong. It's clear that a lot of thought was put into this aspect of the movie. Anyone who's interested by the science of technology will really like this part. The movie is based on the book Expedition by Wayne Barlow, who creates some bizarre alien creatures in the illustrations. They're hard to take your eyes off of because of how irregular their body shapes are and how in most of them, it's difficult to discern which parts of the creature are the head, legs, eyes, or other body parts. It truly looks alien. I think the movie adaptation did a good job capturing the weirdness of the alien creatures, and I imagine those who read the book first must have been pleased to see the animals actually moving. Part of me wishes the movie had more of the same visual style as Wayne Barlow's pictures, with very dark blacks and heavily saturated colors, but it still looks interesting enough as its own movie, with good use of blues, purples, and reds to give it a strange and memorable feel. Not only that, but it sounds great as well. The techno music fits the futuristic, unfamiliar look of the environment, and while some of the alien roars are clearly recognizable stock sound effects, most of them are unique and very fitting. As for the aliens themselves, there's plenty of variety in ecological niches, habitats, and other subjects they explore. Much of it is meant to echo real aspects of nature on Earth, such as in the scenes of predators hunting prey and symbiotic relationships between plants and animals, but they also spend just as much time dabbling in biological sci-fi concepts, giving some of the aliens abilities that don't exist in our world, like flying using jet propulsion or plants using bioelectric shocks. One of my favorite concepts was how a sea one of the probes comes across is covered by cooperative organisms that create a kind of organic-based shield that covers all the water and even has the ability to reach up and grab low-flying creatures for food. Some of the other parts I liked were with the gyrosprinter, a fast-moving herbivore that has merged its legs together, evolving from a quadruped into a biped, and the daggerist, a sort of predatory flying squirrel that feads by stabbing its prey with a proboscis on its throat that's actually an extension of its esophagus. So many of the aliens have these weird features and abilities mixed and mashed together, creating endless possibilities. If I have to pick one thing about the movie that I felt could have been done better, it's that I kind of wish they went into more detail about the biology of the creatures. Really get descriptive and detailed about how their bodies work and how they're able to do the things they do. The first time I watched it as a kid, I had so many unanswered questions about how this world worked, and I wish they'd gone into it more. To be fair though, I think that was done on purpose. The concept of the film is that these probes supposedly gave us our first glimpse of this new planet, and there's still plenty of mystery left to discover. If this were to happen in real life, we of course wouldn't learn everything there was to know about these aliens on our first trip. Alien Planet was a real favorite of mine as a kid because of its unique concept and method of conveying its story, not to mention it's just full of imagination and really influenced my creative thinking. If you're interested in aliens and space travel, or if you're looking for sources of inspiration for your own alien or creature concepts, this is definitely something worth checking out. Thanks for watching! If you enjoy my videos and want to support future projects, click the Patreon link in the description. You'll also receive benefits like early access to videos.